Hey friends, welcome to my channel. My name is Kyle Elliott. I have a couple of updates to share. First of all, obviously I cut all my hair off. I feel so much better in my body. It's pretty affirming to have short hair again. And I always love a good mullet. Also, I've been on testosterone for almost 2 weeks. I ended up dealing with some obstacles when I first started out on testosterone and had to switch the way that I'm taking it. So I thought it might be helpful to share a little bit about what I ran into and also what the process was for me to even get access to it in the first place, which obviously is gonna be very different depending on where you live. I figure sharing this information might be helpful to some of y'all out there. In order for me to begin this process, I had to get what is called a letter of support from my therapist. I had already been in the process of having conversations about my transition with my therapist, so it wasn't really a surprise to her. Once I got that letter, I gave it to my doctor. Then we set up an appointment to do labs to see where my hormone levels were at already. They were within the normal range, a little bit low, but still what you would expect for a person who is assigned female at birth. My doctor only gave me access to 3 different options, applying it through a gel in a pump bottle, and then there were 2 different types of injections, subcutaneous and intramuscular. I couldn't do the intramuscular because the needle is really scary to me. It's a deeper needle, basically. I ended up choosing the gel to begin with, although I was a little bit worried about it because some of the risks that come along with the gel are that it can rub off on other people or your pets. And I have 3 kids, I have 2 dogs, I have 3 partners. So I was pretty concerned about that aspect. I'll explain what my process was to kind of mitigate the risk of that happening. But what I do want to talk about first is that the gel didn't really work for me that long. I was only on it for 5 days. I was told in order for the gel to be effective and getting your T levels where they need to be, that you need to apply it like somewhere on the upper arms or shoulders, even the upper back. You can apply it on your chest as well, but it needs to be above the nipples and not on the nipples. I've heard of people doing it in other places, like on their ankles or their abdomen, but my doctor specifically told me that if you apply it anywhere else, you won't get your T levels where they need to be. And in order for me to feel comfortable, I was changing my sheets daily. I was applying the gel before dinner. That way I had it on for several hours before bedtime. And then before I would go to sleep, I would make sure that I thoroughly washed and cleaned the area before I got into bed, because sometimes my kids like to sleep in bed with me, my youngest child specifically, also my partners and my dogs sometimes too. So I just wanted to be extra careful. That was my process. So I felt pretty good about that, but it still kind of made me nervous. I noticed pretty early on that the area looked red, but I was kind of questioning whether or not I maybe got sunburned. But by the 5th day, it was really clear that every time I would apply it, the skin would turn bright red almost immediately within seconds, and it would stay that way for at least an hour. I was also feeling lightheaded. On the 5th day of applying it, I ended up asking in my support group, hey, is this normal? And everybody that responded was like, absolutely not, that's not normal. Stop taking it immediately and contact your doctor. I cleaned it off. Had been on for about a half an hour that day, and then I reached out to my doctor. Now, it took me about 3 days to get back in with my doctor because they needed to see me before they could switch me to another option. They confirmed that I was allergic to something in it. It wasn't a systemic allergy to the testosterone itself, but it was something in the gel. And I don't typically have sensitive skin, so I was kind of surprised, but apparently it's not super common for this to happen. I actually haven't talked to anybody else who has had this experience, not in my support groups or any of my transgender friends who have tried the gel. Nobody seems to have had that experience, so I guess I'm just special that way. But I ended up switching to the subcutaneous injections because needles frighten me, and I know I have piercings and tattoos, but it's just not the same thing. I thought I would be able to do the sub-Q needles because they're smaller, and I got myself all mentally prepared, and then when I went to the pharmacy pregnancy and saw the needle, I kind of freaked out. I ended up going over to my doctor's office because they offered to show me how to do it and talk to me about the whole process the first time. I chickened out multiple times and had to have somebody there do it for me. Now, my experience with my first injection, from what I've heard, is not super common, but also not completely uncommon. I got some tips from a couple nurse friends of mine who told me to pinch the skin and rub an alcohol pad on the area for about 10 to 15 seconds before I inserted the needle, which I did. I ended up using the adipose tissue on my abdomen as my doctor suggested, and even doing all of that, although inserting the needle didn't hurt, the actual injection itself burnt really bad. It was super intense burning and continued to burn for several hours. I mean, it wasn't like unbearable, like I was crying or super upset about it, but it was painful. It was surprisingly painful, and it was even more surprising that the burning continued for several hours afterward. And now this is 2 days after my injection and I still have pain. It almost feels like if somebody bites you really hard, you know how the area is tender for a while afterward? It feels pretty much exactly like that in about a quarter sized area where I injected the testosterone into my abdomen, or rather the person at the doctor's office injected for me. So I asked around and found a couple of my friends say that they experienced the same thing. One who is a trans man and has been on testosterone for a really long time said that he still experiences that. I was told that it might help to, for some reason, insert the needle further away from my navel, because I think I was about that far from my belly button where I ended up inserting the needle. Also, I think that using a heating pad would probably help. I'm gonna try that next time. That's what my friend suggested and said that it helped him. If any of you watching have experience with this and have any tips or suggestions about eliminating that burning sensation, I would love to hear it. Definitely put that in the comments. I'm sure other people would like to hear it as well. It's taken me a while to make the decision to get on testosterone, being a non-binary person, because I already went through top surgery and that resolved a lot of my dysphoria in my physical body. I needed to come to terms with the fact that getting on testosterone for a period of time to achieve certain changes would actually help me to feel more comfortable in my body, and that it would align my outer expression with my inner experience more fully. Some of the changes that come along with testosterone cannot be reversed, although some of them can. For me, one of my main concerns, although it sounds kind of vain, is that I don't want to lose the hair on the top of my head. But some of the other changes that often come along with taking testosterone are bottom growth, which is basically the clitoris increases in size, an increased libido, and I'm asexual, so that's going to be really interesting to see if that changes. And then facial hair, increased body hair, a deepening of your voice, and also fat redistribution. A lot of the changes with hair growth, hair loss, and also the deepening of your voice tend to be permanent, whereas from what I understand, bottom growth tends to go away after you get off of testosterone, and fat redistribution tends to also revert back. Essentially, it's like going through another puberty, and the changes, which ones happen first or how intense certain changes are, all depend on genetics. And beyond the physical changes, I also had a lot to process around how becoming more visibly transgender in the world will change my level of safety and also my positionality in the world. Even though being perceived as a cis woman comes along with certain risk, transphobic people don't feel comfortable around people whose gender expression they don't understand. There are so many ways that my experience is going to change based on how people will receive me, how people will treat me, how people will perceive me in the world once they're no longer clear on what they think is my gender identity. But in the end, life is so short. All of those things don't outweigh my need to live authentically as myself. I'm really grateful that I can even access trans-friendly healthcare, that I can access hormones, and that I was able to switch when I ran into some difficulty. The process in general can be pretty exhausting if you don't have support as well. And I do have a pretty good circle of supportive partners and friends and chosen family, even if a lot of my family are transphobic and not in my life because I chose for it to be that way. So in general, I'm really excited and really looking forward to the changes. And I'm also excited to share them with y'all. I will be doing updates probably every few months. But I guess that's about it. That's all I have to share so far, being only 2 weeks on testosterone. I hope that you found this information helpful, even if there are some differences in the steps and the entire process involved in accessing it in your area. Hopefully this at least gave you an idea of how to get started if it's something that you're interested in. And of course, if there's anything that I didn't cover, anything that was unclear, or additional questions that you have, definitely ask in the comments below. Remember to like and subscribe. Thanks so much for being here. Until next time, take care and be well.